My name is Stanislav Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and in this lesson, we're going to be taking a deep dive into Apple Motion templates. I recently got a message from a user on YouTube asking me a few different questions. The first question is, what's the difference between just rendering something out from Apple Motion and bringing it into Final Cut as opposed to using title templates or generator templates in Final Cut Pro? Here's my title. I want to be sure that I export this so I can bring it into Final Cut. So I'm just going to turn off a couple of these items here to make sure I have some transparency. And I'm going to go ahead and export this by going to Share, Export Movie. I'm going to render this out, make sure I have my alpha channels, hit Next. I'm just going to place this on my desktop. I can use a Final Cut and Motion as standalone programs. However, by using different title templates, I can easily drag and drop that and retime them right into my timeline. I want to be able to click on this title, and maybe I don't necessarily want that color. Maybe I want it to be purple, and I want to replace some of this text. So now I have that rendered out, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to import that into my timeline. And now I'm going to go ahead and place this right on top. And as I'm looking through this, I'm thinking to myself, you know what, that's a little harsh. I can't really see through that so much. Well, maybe I'll just change some of the blend mode. Yeah, that's working a little bit better, but now my font is a little bit off. So using my templates, you'll notice here's my same title that I just had, but I can rearrange any of these items. If I want to grab this and place this over here, and I'm going to place this up over here. And I have all my published parameters that I have accessible. If you're wondering, I'm using Motion VFX's 3D title text. Motion VFX creates some excellent plugins. They are not paying me for this endorsement, but because I'm using one of their titles for this demo, this is from their 3D text pack. I highly recommend checking them out. So that's the benefits of using title templates versus rendering things out. Another question I had is, what should I start with when I'm making a project? If I go to File, New, which of all these different options do I pick? Do I pick a motion project? Do I pick a generator, a title, a transition, or an effect? It really depends on what exactly you're trying to do. If you know that you're going to end up with an effect, you might want to choose making an effect. In prior versions of Motion before 5.4, you were kind of locked to whatever specific one you started with. It could be a little challenging to change it into, like, say, a title. Certain projects have certain features. If I just go into a title, that's going to create that title background. So if you remember from my title template lessons, this is a special background that only exists in title projects. So anything that you do to this title will affect the background video that you're using in Final Cut. If I had an effect, the same would be true here. In 5.4 and newer though, we can actually convert our project to any other kind of project. If I convert my project to a transition, it's going to say we're going to need to make a new placeholder for transition A, transition B. And I'm just going to say use our title background. And now we have those two special layers that only exist in transition effects for Final Cut Pro 10. So it really depends on what you're using it for. Again, for me, I personally start with a composition, do anything I need to do, because it lets me easily change that. If I go ahead and hit Save As, it's going to save it as a Final Cut Pro transition. The same is true is if I have an effect project open and I hit Save As, it's going to want to save it as a Final Cut Pro effect. So what exactly happens when we save these Final Cut Pro effects, transitions, title templates, or generators? Basically, what happens every time you save one of these different effects or presets, they get stored in a special folder in your user movies motion templates. If I go to my motion templates, you'll notice that I have my effects, and under my effects, there's my AV Ultra effect, and we have our awful TV that we created in lesson 24. I also have my generators, and you can see I have several different generators here, along with my titles, so here's all my different title packs. If I open up one of these, you can see it is a title template. It has a preview of whatever that title template is, along with a large image and a small image that shows up as previews in Final Cut Pro 10. If I save it as a composition, I can save it anywhere. But once I save it as a generator or title or transition, it will always go into this folder. the last question that I had was, what happens if we try to adjust any of the titles that are built in to Final Cut Pro 10? I've got this boogie lights that's included with Final Cut Pro 10. And just like in any other of our title templates or generators, we can right click these and open it in Motion. The main difference is if it is a built-in Final Cut Pro effect, it'll say open a copy in Motion. Whereas if I go to, let's say, one of mine, this askew, this will say open in Motion. So you won't have to worry about ever overwriting things in Apple Motion unless it's one of your original ones. So if I open this title askew to an Apple Motion and I make any changes to this and hit save, that will technically overwrite the original title that's there. However, if I go to this boogie lights and I open a copy in Motion and I make any changes, so as an example, we're going to go to my inspector and I'm going to change this color to a green and I'm going to change this white to a red. And now you can see that that's adjusted there. I'm going to make that size a lot larger. And if I go to save as, I'm going to say we want to leave this as is, and I'm just going to say boogie lights, and it won't let me save it in that basics. It's going to make me pick a different category to place it in. If by some chance I do place it in the same folder, all that's going to do is make a secondary copy in my Final Cut Pro document. So you can see there's my boogie lights copy. So you don't have to worry about ever overwriting the ones that are built in with Final Cut Pro 10 and Apple Motion. However, if you have any custom ones like I have here and you make any changes and you name it the same thing or hit save, it will overwrite those changes. So that's a good breakdown of why you should use templates and how they really work and where they're stored in Final Cut Pro 10 and Apple Motion. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberto with AV Ultra. Hopefully you found this useful, and thanks a lot for watching.